Episode 2, Tantrum Mayhem.
Rapper City is mostly a peaceful city, full of kind and respectful people. And no matter how different we are from one another, we are all one big community. However, like all cities, Rapper City has its own problems.
What was that?
Somebody must be throwing a temper tantrum.
What? But who would do that?
Yo, 2001 Productions. Chris Bird.
Tez. What are you doing here?
There's a 36-year-old woman throwing a temper tantrum at a Target store nearby and she ain't gonna stop until someone gives her what she wants. We got to call the popo now.
Huh? Why would a grown woman be throwing a temper tantrum at a store? What could she possibly want so badly to act so crazy?
She been gone goo goo gaga over a Barbie doll.
Whoa, hold on a second. Goo goo gaga? You mean she's been acting like a baby over a Barbie doll?
Hey, I didn't stutter. She ain't gonna stop throwing no fit till somebody gives her a doggone Barbie doll.
Uh-oh. It sounds like we got a childish mom on the loose.
Everybody run for your lives.
Hurry, Robert. Come on, Vaminos.
You failed. Okay, now we really gotta call the police.
Agreed. We cannot let this slide.
Attention, everyone. We interrupt this program with some breaking news. This just in. We got ourselves a childish woman on a rampage. The police and the justice crows are at the Target store right now trying to de-escalate the situation, but the woman who started the riot is not cooperating. Will she ever calm down? And more importantly, who can stop her?
Oh no. A childish woman on a rampage? At a Target store? That's a really serious offense. Well, I'm not gonna let this slide. This looks like a job for the Dogs of War. Now to call in the others. Alright, Dogs of War. Listen up, we got one childish woman causing a huge fuss inside that Target store over there. We need to get in there and help the police and the Justice Crows calm her down.
How we gonna do that?
Bruno, check to see if there are any more innocent civilians inside. You and Beto will be reinforcements to help evacuate the rest of the shoppers.
No problemo, Eliza.
Roger.
And Richmonda, you and I will help the police and the Justice Crows contain the mystery childish woman.
Okay, Eliza.
And Ronald, if the woman we're after gets really desperate, you'll help me carry her all the way out of the store.
Roger that, Eliza.
All right. Dogs of War, we're going in.
That new hair is so annoying.
She needs to stop.
Everyone, move. Clear out. Childish woman on the loose.
Was that Petro Adamovich?
Come on. They monos. Get out of here. Go.
I'm seeing it, but I don't believe it. Petro and Bruno are helping us evacuate the rest of the Target customers.
They're not the only ones.
Eliza and Richmonda?
What are you two girls doing here? And why are you dressed like that?
Officer McShane, don't you see what's going on here? Those two, Petro and Bruno, they're members of the Dogs of War.
And they must have come here to help us.
You got that right, girl.
What's this I hear about a childish woman on a rampage in this store?
You see that family over there?
Who is that family? And why is that woman lying down on the floor crying like that?
Beware, Eliza, for we are in the presence of Kate Bennett, Crimson Skull 18's version of the childish mom.
A childish mom?
Not the same childish mom. Kate Bennett was created by Crimson Skull 18 for the real Random Lezzy to feature in her videos. But she still acts as childish as the original childish mom, Bridget, who was originally created by someone named Starlight Chan Garnet.
But why is this Mrs. Bennett throwing a temper tantrum like that over there?
Because her amour, Stephen Bennett, wouldn't buy her a Barbie doll.
A Barbie doll? She's causing this big of a fuss over a Barbie doll? That's so funny it's stupid.
Richmonda.
Sorry, Eliza. But come on, a Barbie doll? Am I the only one hearing this?
Richmonda, focus. This is no laughing matter. We need to get that woman out of the store before she makes a big mess around here.
You heard the officer. Now, We're going over there to help the Bennets stop their matriarch from continuing her temper tantrum. No funny business.
Okay, Eliza, I understand. No funny business.
Everybody stand clear. We'll handle this.
You think those two are gonna stop that childish mommy?
Well, knowing Richmonda, she single-handedly knocked Tobias Tyson down in one full swing when we were protecting the Coopers from him and his gang.
Richmonda really did that?
Guess so, boss.
I want a Barbie doll, 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 I want a Barbie doll. Please, Steven, buy me a Barbie doll.
Kate, stop it. Just stop it. How many times do I have to tell you that you're too old for a Barbie doll?
Ugh. This is so embarrassing.
I agree with you, Joey. Why can't our mom act mature for once?
Mommy's acting like a baby. This is so funny.
Okay, break it up, girl. Joke's over here.
Are you guys the family of that woman throwing a temper tantrum over there?
Yes. My name's Stephen Bennett. I'm her husband. Right next to me are three kids. Joey, Sally, and Anna.
Are you too?
We are the dogs of war. My name's Eliza. I saw on the news that your wife/mom has been going on a childish rampage in here.
Hey. I'm not childish. Don't call me childish. I'm just upset because my entitled Kevin of a husband won't buy me a Barbie doll. Please. Tell him to buy it for me.
Mrs. Bennett, answer me this. If you're not childish, would you be throwing a temper tantrum in front of everyone in the store? Even in front of your own family? Huh?
I'll stop throwing a temper tantrum if they buy me the Barbie doll.
No. I told you a million times already. You're too old to play with Barbie dolls.
If you wanna keep acting like this, it would be wise for you to leave the store right now and go back home with your family.
No. I'm not leaving until you entitled Kevins and Karens buy me a Barbie doll. Is it that complicated for you to do that one simple thing for me? No way.
Please refrain from any more childish behavior in front of your family.
Stop calling me childish and buy me the Barbie doll.
We warned you. We'll be forced to drag you out.
No, 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 don't drag me out of Target, 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 don't drag me out of Target.
Then stand up, walk over to wherever you and your family parked, and wait for them to get in the car with you so that you can go home peacefully. Is it that complicated? No.
No, ho, 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 ho. I don't wanna go home.
All right. You asked for it. Ronald, now.
Hey. Put me down. Help. Steven, Joey, Sally, Anna, I'm being kidnapped. Help, help, help.
Quiet. You're not being kidnapped. We're just taking you to your family's car. Mr. Bennett, which one of the cars outside is yours?
It's white with black bumpers.
Thanks. All right, dogs of war. Let's get this woman out of here.
Put me down, you entitled Kevins and Karens. I do not deserve to be treated like this. This is not dignified. Put me down.
Stop it. Just stop it.
Those dogs of war just kicked our mom out of Target.
Yeah. I don't believe this.
Mom even got carried away like an army of soldiers or carrying something heavy.
Unless you want to go to jail for causing a big disturbance on public property, stay in the car until your family takes you home.
This is so unfair. I just wanted a Barbie doll.
Shut up. You have the right to remain silent. And sit there and wait for your family. One other thing before we go. Stop crying like a motor car. You're 36 years old and a married woman. Not a motor car.
Have a nice day, childish mom.
I can't believe I just got kicked out of Target by three kids for throwing a temper tantrum over a Barbie doll. This is not fair.
You know, I may have been a little hesitant because of whose jurisdiction the childish mom was, but you kids actually did a good job. You five in a matter of minutes helped us evacuate the rest of the shoppers and kicked her out of the store to avoid further disruption.
No problemo, officer.
What can I say? Those kids are heroes.